Vous avez regardé Jour le plus long?
Pardon?
Le film Jour le plus long?
Oui.
Il y a une scène là. C'est pour ça que moi c'est émouvant parce que.
Ouais.
Le Jour le plus long, c'est le film de guerre. Hein. Face au débarquement.
Ouais, ouais, ouais.
Il y a le jeu, il y a ce pône, le film.
J'ai vu la dame qui a dit, vous la porte.
C'est parce qu'il y a quelqu'un qui a suivi un monsieur qui est allé aux toilettes, qui ne fait pas partie des cafés.
Ah, alors donc,
c'est là que vous avez permis de m'envoyer.
Oui, il
n'y
a pas de souci.
Merci, madame. Désolée. Hein.
Voilà
le souci qui s'est passé. Hein.
Those are the remnants of the World War II. Going up.
He falls down here. So we've got an underground hospital here as well. This is where all the lavender slept.
Nothing, just some wood. Nothing.
Whoa!
Is it a
Yeah, it takes you back to the bunker, personnel bunker.
Yeah.
Curiously in the window of the Southern House, Captain Stein and his meteorological team made their prediction of Demoiselle Eisenhower and the combined Jesus plan. He predicted a break in the weather that could last between 24 and 36 hours. The decision to launch rested squarely on the shoulders of General Eisenhower. Over 5,400 assault craft with 156,000 men at Red Sea. Three various other mortars, almost 11 aircraft, and a train procession of vehicles.
Kind of out of that thing, but it could be. Because they started off, I lost them out of sight.
This is the last alerting announcement of the Green Headquarters Allied Expeditionary Force,
General Dwight D. Eisenhower. Soldiers, sailors, and airmen of the Allied Expeditionary Force. You are about to embark upon the Great Crusade. You are to be a man of these bandits.
Ah, la petite maison, oui.